Do that big thing again. That was cool. Like that. Yeah, there we go. I like that. It's a good open.
Hi, I'm Lilly. In this video, you're going to see me lead somebody to the Lord with the Jesus at the Door card. I had been led to the Lord with this same card, and stepping out for my first time, I felt really sick and I didn't want to do it, but I had the boldness and I went out and did it, and it was awesome. He accepted the Lord into his heart.
Pray, but praying is like talking through a door. You know he's there somewhere, but you don't know him personally.
Yeah.
Visualize wearing a backpack. If we filled it with all of your sin, would it be heavy?
Yeah.
That represents your debt with God. It stops you from having a relationship with him. If you owed the bank $10,000 and I gave you a check for that amount, and you deposit it into your bank, what would happen?
The bank would take it.
Your debt would be clear.
Oh, yeah.
I had a problem with that one. Honestly, I did. That's what Jesus did for you on the cross. He wrote a check signed in his blood so that he's standing at the door of your heart wanting you to cash it. If Jesus were here right now, would you let him in?
Yeah.
Can you see the wind?
Like, if you think about the wind, like when it's blowing.
Oh, no.
You can't see it, no.
But you can feel it, right?
Yeah.
Like the wind, Jesus is here right now. May I pray for you to feel his presence?
Yeah.
Can
yeah.
I touch you? Sure. Your shoulder?
Showing, yeah?
Yeah. Sure. This is my first time.
She's just learning, yeah.
Dear Heavenly Father, please change the atmosphere. Sorry, what was your name?
Sean.
Sean. Change the atmosphere where Sean stands right now. So, let him feel your spirit.
Yeah, Lord, we just thank you for Sean. Thank you that you love him so much. We ask you to bless him. Bless him and his family today. Thank you that this is not a coincidence that we stop him today, that we're passing as he's passing by, and that you want to get his attention. You love him so much, and you want him to know how much you love him. So I pray right now that he'd feel your touch, he'd feel your spirit, and he'd know, Lord, that you want him to see who you made him to be and who you created him to be, in Jesus' name. I just feel for you, bro. As I'm praying for you, the Lord, just show me. I just feel for you that you've been kind of asking yourself, have you got kids?
You have a son.
Yeah, son, yeah. And I just feel that you've been like going through a stage in your life and you're like, man, I want to be like a good man. I want to be like a good father. And you've had some of those reflective, sort of contemplative thoughts recently where you've been like, man, what am I doing with my life and kind of how am I living it out? Am I achieving my goals? And some of those deeper things, you've been going through a bit of a season where you've just been getting a bit more raw about some of these areas of your life and looking at things a little differently. It's almost like you're in a second chapter of your life. You had your way that you lived, more maybe like wild card, maybe more way, but now you're in this second zone of your life where things are changing a little bit, and it's almost like you're trying to find your place in this new space, if that makes any sense. Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
And I really feel we're stopping you today because the Lord wants you to know that you're already in your heart. You're like, I want to live differently. You're already in that place where I want to do things differently. And that's why Jesus is getting your attention to say, I want to help you live differently. So while we were praying for you, did you feel anything inside? Any different
feeling?
Felt good.
Yeah.
Did you feel something like physically different inside, like a warmth or tingling, anything at all inside in your body? In any way?
Felt good in my heart.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So like, you noticed the difference from before we spoke to you and then when we were speaking to you? Could you
feel a lot calmer.
Yeah, come on. Yeah. Come on, that's cool. Yeah.
I was having a bad day before.
Okay.
And now I'm on a better day.
Come on, it's awesome. And you know, Jesus, one of his names in the Bible was the Prince of Peace.
Yeah.
So when you get around his presence, you can feel that peace, you know.
Yeah.
So could we ask you, would you have enough faith to believe that Jesus is here right now?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so you want to just say the last thing?
Now for the last thing, to turn from the road you're on without Jesus, change direction and follow him. Do you want to follow him?
So that means, just to real clarify, it's just kind of like, Sean, how old are you, bro? 29. So 29 years, Sean's been on this road without Jesus, just doing your thing, finding your feet, and then the Lord's like, turn around and let me show you what I have for you. Like, come follow me, come follow him, and let him lead you like a shepherd leads the sheep. And trying that new direction and saying, do you know what, I'm going to let you lead my path. That's the kind of difference in relationship, not being religious, but just saying, man, I want to know you. That's the difference, if that makes sense. Just want to clarify that. So would you say you'd follow him in that way?
Yeah.
Come on, awesome.
I'm 29 too, and I spent the last 4.5 years of my life just drinking every single day.
Yeah.
And he came and knocked on my door. And it took me a few days, but finally I quit drinking, and I'm 97 days sober.
That's awesome.
Come on, yeah. It's amazing. When I was 24...
That's all the Lord.
Yeah, no, it's totally changed it around. And we're actually, what we're doing right now is we're filming. I'm an evangelist, and I travel all over the world. But I'm a pastor of a church also in Woodland. I live here now in Woodland, Washington, just like 25 minutes north. Yeah. And we have a church here. So we're filming some of our guys that have had their lives changed around. We're filming what's called The Journey of a Disciple, how it happened, how did Jesus change their life. And this is Lily's story that we're filming at the moment, which is why we stopped you, and we're just kind of out, hanging out, stopping people. But when I was 24, I was cocaine addict, alcoholic, friends with gangsters, living a crazy life, man. And I had a drug overdose and saw the gates of hell. And I'm like, God, keep me alive and I'll follow you. Yeah. I didn't think I was bad enough to go to hell, but I realized, man, this is crazy. This thing is like, there's two roads. Jesus said one wide road that you've been on all your life, and that takes you straight to hell. Or there's a narrow one that leads you to heaven.
Yeah.
And we're just trying to get people on the right path, you know? So for us, it's not about being religious, it's about loving Jesus.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what we're talking about, you know what I mean? So for you, you're like letting him in and saying, here's all my garbage. Now I want to come and get to know you.
Yeah.
And then take those steps, you know? So the Bible tells us if you pray and you mean it from your heart with your mouth and you really mean it, then he comes in. So Lily's just going to walk you through this prayer. So all you got to do is just repeat this with her from your heart with your mouth. That's good.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I
open the door of my heart.
I'm sorry for my sin. I choose to follow you. I make you the Lord of my life. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. In your name I pray, amen.
Okay, and I just want to pray for you once more. Father, we just thank you for Sean, Lord. Thank you for meeting him. Thank you that he's here today and that he had an openness in his heart to want to listen. And I thank you, Lord, that you are doing something wonderful in his life. And I pray tonight that he would go away from here knowing that this is the invitation to the beginning of the rest of his life, the invitation to the start of something brand new that you always created him for. Lord, I pray right now, Holy Spirit, I ask you to let him feel you right now in his heart. Would he be able to feel the touch of your presence, feel the love of your spirit moving through him right now, to know that you love him so much and that you've got an amazing future for him and that you're inviting him into an adventure. I feel that you're showing you're a man of adventure. You're a man who likes the adrenaline, who likes to have that the wild experiences. And I feel that you had that in your past. And you're trying to calm down, but you know what? The Lord, he doesn't want you to calm down. He just wants you to change the thing that you've been wild for and be wild for him. And I feel that there's a wild, passionate man inside of you, and you just haven't had the real purpose to live for and to be passionate about. And God wants to give you that and show you that what your mission is. So we bless this man, help him now take those steps towards you, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
Actually, bro. That makes sense?
Thank you.
Come on. So we'd love to invite you to come and connect with us, man. Are you from this area? Longview?
From Lexington.
How far is that?
It's just Kelso.
Like, okay. Kelso. Okay, cool. So we're based in Woodland. We are starting a church in January in Longview. But we meet right now in Longview. We have a new believer group that we do. So every week we have new people. And it's kind of real relaxed, man. But our main church is in Woodland. So we'd love to invite you to check it out sometime. Yeah. What's your number? I'll shoot you a message. And then, okay. And then I'll basically send you a bunch of the info where we're at, yeah? Do you work?
Yeah.
Yeah, what do you do?
I build police cars over here at Ford.
That's cool.
Okay, you got me. So yeah, I'll send you the info, bro. I'd encourage you to take a step, because the truth of it is now the most important part is like Jesus, he wants to open up a future for you.
Yeah.
But you could take that step and check it out and see what it's like.
Hey, thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Have a good one. Hope to see you again.
Oh, thank you.